You're watching The Morning Show on Fox 4 Beaumont.
You're watching The Morning Show on KBTV Fox 4. It is a Thursday, 16th day of May for 2019. Dan Gresham along with Jillian Furtick and meteorologist Dana Melanson. Delighted that we are part of your morning and also delighted with the sunshine that we're watching up in the Piney Woods this morning. Beautiful at the lake.
Yeah, great day to have tea times early this morning.
With, no kidding.
I want to say cool start, but certainly cooler than the last couple of three mornings as opposed to low and mid-70s. We're in the mid and upper 60s this morning. It's our live weather network of cameras from Do Good Credit Union again, coming to you from Rayburn Country. Just a nice shot. St. Anthony Cathedral School here in Beaumont starts the morning off at 72 and 88% on our humidity reading. And again, we're looking at calm winds. And the calm winds have been pretty much standard across the area for a good part of the morning hours. And of course, that might attribute to the rapid heating too that we're going to be seeing. I think we'll exceed 80. Probably by 11 o'clock, and certainly see some upper 80s for both the coast and the lakes. And along with the warm temperatures, guys, we are bringing rain chances back, unfortunately. Yes, it's not a big chance, but we'll talk about that and the timing of it coming up in our full forecast.
All right. Exactly what do you think the time would be if we left here at 8:02 before we got to Rayburn Country and the golf course?
Depends on who's driving. Me... we could be there
45 minutes.
Oh, easy. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Well, maybe you should drive.
Yeah. 8:40 maybe we could be there.
You fly, I'll buy. I'll get the gas if you can get us up there by that. It does look great up there though this morning. It looks pretty good everywhere you go. Mm-hmm. It's 8:02. If you want an update on the forecast with Dana, don't forget you can also go to fox4beaumont.com. And our headlines, the race for Democratic presidential nomination in 2020. Well, the list of those in just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah, the latest to throw their hat into the big ring, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio. His campaign released the video this morning of himself introducing to voters, and he plans to visit the early primary states of Iowa and South Carolina soon. De Blasio was first elected New York City's mayor in 2013 and was reelected to a second term 4 years later. Before that, he was a member of the New York City Council and served as the city's advocate. De Blasio is now the 23rd major candidate seeking the Democratic presidential nod in 2020.
The fate of abortions across the country under fire.
This as additional states propose heartbeat bills and as others aim for a near total ban. Ray Bogan has more on how these discussions could affect reproductive rights.
Alabama's governor signed the nation's strictest abortion law Wednesday. It nearly bans all abortions unless the mother's life is in danger. Now, lawmakers from other states are on a similar path.
We want to protect babies. We want to make abortion not just illegal, but unthinkable.
Missouri is set to take up a heartbeat bill banning abortions after roughly 8 weeks.
If for any reason any court were to overturn that, we have a tiered severance package, which would actually kick it to a 14-week ban.
Georgia, Kentucky, Mississippi, and Ohio have already outlawed abortions once a doctor detects a heartbeat. In Wisconsin, legislators going one step further, the state assembly passing a Born Alive anti-abortion bill Wednesday.
When a baby survives an abortion, takes that first breath of life, that doctors are required to do everything that they can do to ensure that baby survives.
Legal analysts say these state laws will face opposition throughout the federal court system.
Usually, when there's a major change in a constitutional in constitutional interpretation, it's the Supreme Court that makes the change. So lower courts themselves feel bound by the existing Supreme Court decisions. There are several cases already on the court's calendar for consideration.
Experts cite the conservative tilt of the Supreme Court as a reason why states are trying to pass bills that could challenge Roe versus Wade. In Washington, Ray Bogan, Fox News.
President Trump unveiling a new immigration plan today. Senior administration officials say the hope is that congressional Republicans will unify around the changes.
But some have concerns about what isn't included in the proposal. John Lawrence has more.
The Trump White House says it's time to fix immigration.
A corrupt and broken system that can be changed in 20 minutes.
Jared Kushner, one of President Trump's senior advisors and son-in-law, was involved in talks related to the plan.
Not one more American life should be lost because our lawmakers failed to secure our borders.
The proposal reportedly secures points of entry, increases border barriers, and creates a merit point system. It avoids the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals, or DACA, family separations, low-skilled immigrants, and the millions of undocumented migrants in the U.S.
What they're saying is you have to be amazingly brilliant. You probably have to be whiter. Diversity visas, again, are gone. And you can't even serve in the military.
Republican Senator Lindsey Graham says the president's plan is not designed to become law. He introduced a bill that changes the asylum process and tries to lessen the flow into the U.S.
Life is better here than it is there. And no amount of money is going to stop people from coming. No matter how high the wall will be built, no matter how many drones you have.
This fiscal year has seen the most apprehensions at the southern border in a decade, according to Customs and Border Protection. I'm John Lawrence reporting.
If Republicans are able to reach a consensus on immigration, they still need to get support from Democrats who are in control of the House of Representatives. President Trump set to meet today at the White House with the president of the Swiss Federation. It comes amid rising tensions between the U.S. and Iran. The White House said in a statement the two leaders will discuss matters such as Switzerland's role in facilitating diplomatic relations and other international issues. It's an indication that Trump could be looking to diffuse tensions by pursuing back-channel negotiations with Iranian leaders. That stands in contrast to Trump's public posturing, sending an aircraft carrier task force group to the Persian Gulf as a show of force.
8:07, finally this morning, I want to take a walk on the wild side. We'll just head for Tennessee.
It is the longest pedestrian bridge in North America, holds more than 200,000 pounds, and at its highest point is more than 140 feet above the ground.
Yeah, it's Gatlinburg's latest attraction and the talk of the town. It's almost 700 feet long. As you mentioned, the longest pedestrian suspension bridge in North America. And it's made up of 129 cedar panels with three glass panels taking off about 15 feet in the middle.
And if you're walking with a purpose, you could get across it in about a minute and a half to 2 minutes. But with this view of the Smoky Mountains alongside you, that's probably not likely.
Nope. If you're worried about the weight limits, don't be. In fact, they say if you had 500 people on this bridge and each person weighed 400 pounds, you'd still be under the weight capacity for that bridge. So it's not a problem. Look at that, though.
That's cool.
Ooh.
I knew what Jillian's reaction would be. That's cool.
Yeah.
Here's
a
person who jumps out of perfectly good airplanes.
Right.
But I'm wondering what your reaction is.
No,
Are you a heights person?
Yeah, as long as I'm totally confident that I'm safe.
Uh-huh. You know, oh, okay.
The kind where you're, you know,
exposed.
Sort of iffy and exposed. Yeah. But that I would like that. I think that would be cool.
I don't think I'd ever be that guy that walks the girder with the handheld camera. You know, you see those, right? But I'm like you with this. I think I'd be okay with that.
But see, and I'm also okay, and I don't think even height matters, like zip lines and things like that.
Right.
So, you know, and although you're exposed, I still feel pretty safe on those, so I'll tackle that.
There's a little adventure there.
Mm-hmm.
But jumping off something, no.
We'll leave that.
I'll save that for.
Yeah. 8 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock. We can jump off into a good forecast this morning, though. Lots of sunshine.
Yeah, and feel pretty safe about that one with, again, temperatures heating up pretty rapidly as the day progresses. We didn't start off with warmer temperatures. In fact, a little bit cooler earlier this morning. We'll have the details next.
Your weather authority.
Good morning, everyone. 11 minutes after the 8 o'clock hour. Thanks for joining us here at the morning show at Fox 4. Well, it looks like I'm on the 18th green, which or 18th fairway up at Rayburn Country. We're here at home in our nice, cool studio. It's a little warm outside where we're in the lower and mid-70s in some locations. But again, it's nice to take a look at this camera because this is one of those instances where not all the cameras are giving us the same view. We got a clear sky here up at Rayburn Country, whereas down close toward Bolivar, our camera there showing the partly cloudy skies. But again, all in all, it will be a warm day. And here in Beaumont, we're at 73 to start the morning off, 87% on our humidity factor. The one constant that's been pretty much evident all morning long is our calm winds. We just hadn't seen much in the form of wind activity, which is, very surprising once you see where the positioning of a ridge of high pressure is that's dictating our weather. And we'll show you that here in just a couple of minutes. Our 6-hour satellite and radar composite, Texas quiet, Louisiana the same, Arkansas, Oklahoma, all under the influence of that high pressure. High pressure giving us stability, high pressure sinking air, prohibiting anything from developing. So again, a quiet pattern building in, and of course, building in on our view here in extreme southeast Texas, southwest Louisiana, more of the same, quiet. And most of the areas seeing nothing in the form of clouds. Kirbyville at 61, we're at 65 in Woodville and most of Tyler County. Hardin County between the mid and upper 60s, and we're at 71 right now in Beaumont. The Jack Brooks Airport climbing. We were at 69 for the longest, 68, 69. Now we're at 76. See that rapid climb as far as our temperatures are concerned. And we'll see that sort of build to areas north of I-10 as the next couple of hours progress. I really pretty confident in thinking by 11 o'clock that 80 mark will be in the rearview mirror. We'll see warmer than 80 by 11 o'clock and even warmer than that, obviously, during for our afternoon highs. Our highs today, again, mid and some areas upper 80s. We'll start off tomorrow morning low and mid 60s again. See the return of the middle 80s in for our Friday and upper 80s by Saturday and Sunday. But here's what I was talking about as far as winds. This is our forecast models, which has us a couple of hours out. But the high is right on top of us. You can see barely anything in the form of wind anywhere in our area. But the positioning of that high keeps that clockwise rotation, adding to the southerly and southeasterly wind component in for the better part of the day today and tomorrow, and the moisture content just supported. And it's by Saturday morning. See a few pop-up showers. It's not going to be much. We'll call for little chance of rain to come about starting tomorrow at 20%. But we're looking at a warm weather day today, upper 80s for the lakes area and the coast with southeast winds, 10 miles per hour. And a check of our extended, sponsored by our friends at Philpott Ford. 87 today and tomorrow, with upper 80s Saturday and Sunday. And we'll start with rain chances tomorrow. We'll ease it in at 20%. And, some models hinted a little better rain on Saturday. I'm confident, at least at this point, at a 30% coverage, but a better chance for rain on Sunday during the afternoon hours.
All right. But doable.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. 50%
after,
absolutely,
I said,
yeah.
Like last week, you don't think much about that.
Yeah.
It's 15 past the hour of 8 o'clock. All right, this one, remember the movie and the story about the rock climber that got caught in the rock and he had to amputate his own leg?
Oh, that's right.
Right?
I remember, yeah.
And they made a movie out of it. Well, kind of a similar story, but this is, to me, a little more interesting because this is a 63-year-old farmer in Nebraska. He had to make a split-second decision, really, save his own life, when he actually stepped into a grain auger last month.
Gosh.
You know those things. Curtis Kaiser said he realized his leg was stuck and he was being pulled into the machine and he knew he had to act quickly. Kaiser alone did not have his phone on him, so he said he felt like his only choice was to cut off his leg with his own pocket knife.
Oh,
so he cut through the torn flesh and the tissue about 8 inches below his knee. Once free, he crawled 200 feet to his house. He said he was afraid he was going to pass out, but he made it. And then he was able to call for help. Kaiser flown to a medical center in Lincoln. He's now home. Says he feels fortunate. Once his leg is healed, says he's going to be fitted for a prosthetic and he should be able to walk again. And he looks forward to getting back out into the fields. Is that incredible?
What do you say after that story?
I mean, it's like that same old thing. All I have is a rusty pocket knife. I mean,
can you imagine feeling like, well, guess I just can't imagine me being able to do that.
And to me, it's that classic, you have to be there.
Yeah,
I guess it was so.
And I'm like you. I think a lot of people would not have the wherewithal to be able to do that.
Oh, no.
And would probably die as a result of it. But this guy was smart enough, you know. And I don't know. Again, I guess being there is a whole lot different than sitting here.
Yeah.
Talking about,
it must be a slow process, this equipment or whatever.
Yeah, I think it was slow enough that, but he knew there was no way out.
Right.
Wow. 17 past the hour of 8 o'clock. a local soul food restaurant going south of the equator this weekend.
We'll have details on this weekend's Taste of Jamaica coming up on Sunday.
As the 2020 elections approach, there are more and more divisions within Democrats in Congress. The loudest voices, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Rashida Tlaib, and Ilhan Omar, have all garnered headlines for being radical and inflammatory. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi has been unable to rein them in, watering down legislation meant to condemn Omar's anti-Semitic rhetoric, turning a blind eye to Tlaib's misguided calls for impeachment, and allowing Ocasio-Cortez's Green New Deal to gain dangerous traction. These three women define the new, extreme, nonsensical tone of the Democratic Party. And it appears that in determining that Pelosi has lost control, a group of freshman Democrats, also all women, have decided to put their foot down and plan for the future of their party. They have formed a joint fundraising committee with the explicit goal of supporting more centrist Democrats like themselves who suffer from the far left's rhetoric. While I disagree with these women on many issues, this is an admirable effort to stop the likes of AOC, Ilhan Omar, and Rashida Tlaib, whose dangerous policies threaten our country. Here's the bottom line. It will be interesting to see whether the centrist Democrat women are able to gain traction and produce results. One thing is for sure, the fact that we are having this conversation does not bode well for Democrats in 2020.
Boris, the far left won't be a model for success for congressional Democrats. Coming up, my thoughts on the freshman women who aren't garnering headlines.
The views expressed by commentators do not necessarily reflect the views of this station.
The sun is high in the sky, a few clouds out there. Right now, we're at Betty Jean's Homestyle Cooking this morning. It's all about soul food. We've had them on before. We've talked chicken and waffles, biscuits and gravy. But on Sunday, they're talking about the spices of Jamaica. Nicole Murray's live this morning. And Nicole, man, that looked so good last segment. I know she's working on something else now.
I know, and she said that her pork chops, her jerk pork chops, are the best out there. She said she can't even keep them going because every time they come in, they sell out really, really quickly. And Chef V joins us. And, of course, talk about, you know you said that there are some secrets in there, but share with us a little bit about what makes it so good, that Jamaican jerk.
Well, the Jamaican jerk, like I said before, we have a special blend, which is our little secret right here. But this right here is just our regular season, and the only thing that's different is, you know, my little secret ingredient. But this, like, have like that red bell pepper, onions, garlic powder, like sugar, cinnamon, and all stuff like that, and then my secret blend, and that give it that special flavor and taste.
Okay. We're gonna season one up right now. So as you do it, is there a certain way to kind of just massage the meat as well to make it tender?
I try to do my my wet first, and I just kind of rub it in. And I don't need a lot, just kind of rub it in like that. And if I do that, and I usually sit it overnight again, so you know that season will like marinate in it. And then I just add my special blend.
Marinated, do you put the season on there as well? You just
Yeah, put the season on it and let it sit overnight, and then that so that flavor, when you eat it, that flavor will be good in it. And here's my little secret ingredient. And I just rub it in and sit it down, and like before I put it on the grill, I kind of spray it with the spam, and that's about it.
And it is ready to go. Wow, you can smell all the different flavors going on in here. And, of course, you have so many different things that you're going to be serving up on Sunday. Give us a little bit of a preview of what's going to be on the menu.
Okay, so for Sunday, the menu is going to be jerk pork chop, jerk chicken wings, oxtail, like brown stew, stew oxtail, curry goat, one of my favorite. And we're going to also be doing the brown stew chicken for the side, mac and cheese, rice and peas or rice and beans, steamed cabbage with carrots, collard greens with smoked turkey neck bone, Jamaican sodas, fried plantain, make to order, and Jamaican folks dancing around.
It sounds like it's going to be a wonderful, wonderful time. And, of course, it is a fundraiser. You're going home. Your father did pass. And so our condolences to you. But he wanted you to have a gathering for him. And so this is for him. And people could come out and be a part of it and enjoy some great Jamaican food.
Okay. All right. So East Texas, make sure you all are here early.
All right, and so with that said, you know, do you have a, well, I know we showed the finished product earlier, but, and it looks excellent, excellent, but of course, you know, the different meats and things like that looks really, really well. I think she's fixing a plate right now that we can maybe send back to you, Jillian, in the studio, so, but it just come on out. It's from noon until 4 o'clock on a Sunday here at Betty Jean's on Dallin. Tossing it back to you in the studio, Jillian.
All right, thanks, Nicole. Hopefully you got to sample some of the goodies this morning. Coming up on 828, still ahead, hundreds from the Newton community show up to honor the life of a longtime coach, and Lamar University police arrest a student they found through an app. We'll have those headlines next on The Morning Show.
One person recovering following a crash overnight in Beaumont.
Lamar police crediting an app with a gun-related arrest.
And 100 bid farewell to a longtime coach in Newton.
You're watching The Morning Show on Fox 4 Beaumont.
Hi there, 30 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock. Well, we've kind of extolled the virtues of sunshine all morning long, because we got off to a good start. But there were a few clouds kind of floating around out there this
morning. Yeah, it's sort of, you know, whatever view you want to look at. Up at Rayburn Country, it was clear. The beach are looking at a lot of clouds. But either way that you look at it, and yeah, here's our camera. It's at Crenshaw Magnet School, right along the coast. And we focus the camera over the Gulf of Mexico. You can see some of the sun's rays, but you can also see the clouds that it had to fight through earlier this morning. Here in Beaumont, we have certainly warmed, and pretty quickly. I mean, we started the morning off in the upper 60s for the most part. We're now have jumped up just within the last 20, 30 minutes to the middle 70s. And so we're going to be seeing these mid and upper 80s reached pretty quick. In fact, I think we'll probably exceed the 80 mark by maybe 11 o'clock. But look for highs to peak right around 87 for the triangle, southeast winds at 10 miles per hour. We still, again, ruled rain out for today, but we'll bring it back at a slow clip tomorrow, 20%, and then a little bit better on Saturday. It's not much, but we'll see it ease up by Saturday. The best rain chance, and we'll focus our efforts on, will be Sunday.
Okay, and at this point, I think most folks could do without any rain.
Oh, I'm
so
with you there,
see
yeah.
It even on Saturday, they'd probably be okay with that. It's 31 past the hour. Thank you, Dana. We'll get another look at the extended before we're done. First, though, in our headlines this morning, one person is recovering following a crash overnight in Beaumont.
It happened on Highway 69. Beaumont police say the crash involved three cars. Officers say one car was attempting to assist another driver and began to turn the car around to face that vehicle to give the car a jump start. That's when police say that driver was hit by a third vehicle traveling northbound. One person was taken to the hospital with non-life-threatening injuries. The freeway closed for several hours for cleanup and an investigation.
Developing this morning, investigators working to determine the cause of a devastating house fire. What you just saw was a jet of fire erupting from a propane tank outside a home in the Aaron community. That's southwest of Jasper.
Two fire departments fought the blaze Tuesday night. The owner was away and no one was hurt. The fire destroyed the home. This story and video comes to us from KJAS Radio. Lamar police are crediting an app with the arrest of a Lamar Institute of Technology student who they say had a gun in his dorm room. Police responded to an anonymous tip on February 14th. The same day, KFDM did a story on the LifeSave app's introduction to the university. 19-year-old Seth Davis was a student at the Lamar Institute of Technology, but lived in the Lamar University dorms. Police officials say guns are allowed in dorms under strict guidelines. The student needs a license to carry, and the gun needs to be secured in a safe along with other conditions. Lamar police are asking everyone to continue downloading the LifeSave app and say this case proves it's working.
The students and the parents can download the app, and it's geared for our campus, and they can report safety concerns, they can report hazardous conditions, they can report suspicious persons, they can report crimes.
Davis faces a third-degree felony charge for unlawful carry of weapons prohibited and tampering with identification numbers, which is a Class A misdemeanor.
Beaumont police need your help this morning. They're trying to find a man suspected of multiple burglaries. According to police, the man burglarized homes and property, then takes the stolen items to local pawn shops and uses the identification card of somebody in jail to pawn the stolen goods. If you have any information on who this man is or where he may be, you need to contact the Beaumont Police Department at 832-1234 or Crime Stoppers at 833-TIPS. You could be eligible for a cash reward.
Well, with all the rain we've had this month, mosquitoes are expected to make their presence felt early next week.
The morning show's Quentin Hope shows us how Jefferson County is preparing for the mosquito invasion.
Jefferson County Mosquito Control is spraying down storm drains and other mosquito-infested areas early this time of year. The reason being?
We've started out pretty wet this month, and I expect that things are going to start picking up. We'll start seeing more mosquito activity.
Kevin Sexton of the Jefferson County Mosquito Control says in early May, Jefferson County has already logged more than 8.5 inches of rain, whereas in the months of February and March, more than 4.5 inches of rain below normal. You get the picture? More rain means more mosquitoes.
Watch out and don't let them eat on.
Cheryl Hale has lived in Beaumont all her life. She says she enjoys the outdoors and not letting a few mosquitoes ruin something she says you can't do anything about, especially for those who aren't accustomed to Southeast Texas pesky insects.
My aunt used to laugh at me. She lived in Minnesota and we'd look for snakes and mosquitoes. And she laughed. It gets 40 below, she said. Why would we have those?
For her, to enjoy the outdoors without being eaten by mosquitoes is simple.
You have to come in earlier and spray good.
We're going to try to knock them down as soon as we can, but we start from behind. We can't start ahead. We always have to wait till they're out before we start spraying. So we're trying to play catch up. So it's going to be a few days before we can start getting on top of it.
In Beaumont, Quentin Hope, The Morning Show.
Mosquito control crews say it's important, remember to keep your lawns and gutters clean and free of excess standing water. Well, more than 50 cyclists in Beaumont participated in the 2019 Ride of Silence. It's a day where cyclists ride to honor those who have been hit by cars.
Yeah, it's an annual event worldwide. KFTM's Casty Wood reports on how this has affected Beaumont riders.
Cyclists gathering together in front of Kickstand Bike Shop in Beaumont to ride in a worldwide annual event honoring those who've been struck by vehicles. This hits close to home for Kickstand store owner.
Kathy Grantham got killed in 2004. She was in my store the day before it happened. A man hit her and killed her. I got that news at the store, closed the store, ran out there. They had already taken her away. But I knew the bike, and so I knew who it was.
Every cyclist knows of someone who's been hit or they've been struck themselves.
I was just riding, and he didn't look up, didn't see me.
T. Lynn Walden was hit by a distracted driver who was on his cell phone.
And came through the intersection and caught me from the side and just threw me. I was really fortunate because no part of my body hit the car, but my body hit plenty of pavement.
He says the worst part was having to call his wife from the back of an ambulance. But even if a cyclist hasn't been hit,
the close calls are always there. It's something we deal with all the time on the road.
Which is why events like these are important, riding to raise awareness. Reporting for The Morning Show, I'm Cassidy Wood.
In 2016, over 18,000 cyclists worldwide were injured in road accidents. 3,500 were killed or seriously injured.
8:37. Finally this morning, a new museum on a mission to tell the story of Lady Liberty.
The Statue of Liberty Museum opens this week, just steps away from the statue. The 26,000 square feet museum contains theater space, exhibits, and artifacts taken from the base of the statue.
Yeah, artifacts like Lady Liberty's original torch on display in a glass room overlooking the actual Statue of Liberty. The museum opens to the public today and will be managed by the National Park Service.
About 4.3 million people visited the Statue of Liberty in 2018.
Yeah, and you may remember earlier, I guess it was actually last week, we ran a story about the fact that the Park Service is ending commercial tours mm-hmm. of the statue because they just have so many coming,
yeah,
you know, to visit. So this, I think, is also a way they're hoping to divert people.
There's maybe, still a way to see
yeah,
and learn.
Into the museum yeah. instead of necessarily going. I did not know this. I did not remember this. Do you know who created the frame for the Eiffel Tower? I just gave it away. Statue of Liberty. The same man who built the Eiffel Tower.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I didn't realize that till the other day.
I didn't know that either.
All right, 38 past the hour. Coming up next, we get a look at the latest entertainment news. That is the back of Mr. Kenny DeVille this morning as he heads on out. Like the rest of us, he's glad you're mm-hmm. joining us this morning. You know, what type of financial fraud is most common in Texas?
And Caesar salads are being recalled from HEB. Jane King has those stories and more in today's Texas Business Report.
Hello, Texas. Taylor Texas Farms recalled more than a half ton of ready-to-eat Caesar salad with chicken products from HEB shelves. The salads are labeled HEB Shake, Rattle, and Bowl Caesar Salad with Chicken. They were misbranded, according to the USDA, and actually contained anchovies, which were a known allergen, and that was not on the product label. Well, hemp production, getting the green light from the Texas Senate. It would authorize Texas farmers to grow hemp, marijuana's non-psychoactive cousin, and allow the crop to be processed into finished goods in the state as well. Well, the city of Austin has kicked off its family-friendly workplace initiative. In it, businesses are encouraged to take a close look at their practices and policies that affect young families. And Texas ranks fifth for identity fraud. Security.org says the number of reports in the state of ID theft, 45,000. The state also had high rates of debt collection schemes and imposter scams. From the NASDAQ market site in Times Square, I'm Jane King with your Texas Business Report.
All right, time for a little movie news now with a little music thrown in.
Here's David Daniel with the Hollywood Minute.
Mr. David Crosby.
Do you ever wonder why you are still alive?
I don't know. No idea, man.
He's a two-time Rock and Roll Hall of Fame inductee with Crosby, Stills, and Nash and The Byrds. Now fans can get to know the music legend like never before in the documentary David Crosby, Remember My Name. The trailer for the film just dropped. The doc hits theaters in July.
It was a big event.
Jemaine Clement is the latest addition to the Avatar sequels. The co-creator of Flight of the Conchords and What We Do in the Shadows is set to play a marine biologist in the franchise. The first sequel is due out in December of 2021.
That to me is the heart of the story.
Ryan Reynolds is in a video game in a movie. The actor stars in the film Free Guy as a bank teller who discovers he's merely a background character in a video game. Filming has begun in Boston. Free Guy is due in theaters next summer. In Hollywood, I'm David Daniel.
Alec Baldwin wants a court to dismiss the lawsuit against him involving a November confrontation over a parking spot.
A man sued the actor in March for pain and psychological trauma. He says Baldwin shoved him with both hands, then punched him in the jaw. In his motion to dismiss, Baldwin says he never punched the guy and only lightly tapped him on the chest. The actor also says he has video evidence to prove his story. Baldwin additionally counters the man's claim, saying his medical records show he was only prescribed one dose of Tylenol. Baldwin pleaded guilty in January to a harassment violation in Connecticut with the dispute that's not considered a crime in New York.
For more on that and other stories trending, you can tune into the Daily Mail tonight here on Fox TV. Coming up next, going to check back in with Kelsey.
We're getting a preview of a three-day grand opening for a new sporting goods store here in Beaumont.
And despite constant media coverage, freshman Democrat Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez doesn't represent the voices of every woman in her congressional class. And now some are speaking out. The 2018 midterms were all about Democrats gaining control of the House and breaking into Republican strongholds. Ocasio-Cortez's win did nothing to add to the majority. Five freshman Democrats in the House are reminding the party and voters of this. Representatives Elaine Luria, Abigail Spanberger, Alyssa Slotkin, Mikey Sherrill, and Chrissy Houlihan recently formed a joint fundraising committee aimed at Democrats who won tough races. Ocasio-Cortez brings excitement and a rebranding of the party, essential for newer voter interests. But Democrats need to keep their eyes on the prize. If there is hope for flipping Senate seats, they need to look towards promoting and advancing the new women in Congress who won tough races in Republican territory. Let's get to the point. Speaker Pelosi has consistently urged Democrats to play to the center, a message in stark contrast of prominent new congresswomen like Ocasio-Cortez. Winning back voters who turned to Trump in 2016 and getting a bigger slice of the electoral map won't be done using the far left as a model.
Nine, you've got a chance to win some prizes and some gift cards from a brand new sporting goods store that's opening here in Southeast Texas.
Yep, Dick's Sporting Goods celebrating its grand opening at Parkdale Mall, getting started tomorrow at 8 a.m.
And Kelsey is there this morning. And I kind of have a real quick question before you get into the golf simulator. Are they open now? Because, I mean, is it a soft opening and then a grand opening going on during the weekend?
Yes, so I actually didn't know that until today, but there is a sign hanging up outside that says now open. You can come in today and shop, but my suggestion would be to come in today and kind of pre-shop. That's what I've been doing because I'm waiting until this weekend and hopefully getting one of those gift cards so that I can spend some of my money that way. And I also got a coupon in the mail, so you should look in your mailbox. Mine was 20% off of your purchase, so check for that before you come out and shop the new Dick's Sporting Goods. But yeah, if you can't wait, you can come on out today. They are open, and the big grand opening starts tomorrow morning. So we did want to show you this golf section that they have here, and this is something that is really helpful for people who want to buy a new club and they maybe need some guidance or maybe want to try it out, right, Sinead?
Right. So, you know, we're only a couple of weeks away from Father's Day. So for those golfers out there that are fathers, you guys want to come out here and get fitted for the perfect set of clubs, we're able to do that. Fortunately, in all of our stores, we're able to offer a fitting bay, which our experts can look at your swing, kind of look at how you're swinging, and based on those results, they can custom fit a full set of clubs for you.
That's really awesome. I really don't know much about golf, so I don't know the details of how much this helps, but I'm assuming you wouldn't want to step out on a golf course with a club that you've never swung.
Right. So obviously, you know, we're all different heights, we have different strengths. So what this can do is help guide us to give you the best fitting equipment. We know that whether you're a golf enthusiast or just learning to golf, the major part of your game is that you want to make sure you have the right equipment. Mm-hmm. And we're able to provide that here for you.
And I will let you know that I did take a few swings over here, and it was just as terrible as it was last time I was live on air at 5 under, not being able to hit the ball. But you have all the different brands of golf equipment that people would want or need, right?
Absolutely. So we offer all of the brands that a PGA golfer would use to someone who's just learning. So from your youth to women's golf clubs to anything you need to be a golfer, we have it here.
And I know you have a golf specialist, one who is here this morning. Is that something that's available as soon as today, tomorrow, this weekend?
Absolutely. So our golf team is here all the time. So if you have any golf needs, we're able to help fit you and get you ready for the golf season coming up.
Yeah. I can't remember. Were there any golf giveaways on the prize?
I do believe we have a golf club that is on the gift locker, so come out and possibly win that.
Yeah, and I will post a picture of that. I've already posted a picture of the locker, but I'll post the exact prizes and the times that they will be given away. So again, if you guys want to know the rundown of the grand opening, tomorrow morning and Saturday morning, it's 8 a.m. Sunday morning, it's 9 a.m. But you want to get here early because once you get in line, you'll get wristbands. And the wristbands you can trade in for a gift card of a mystery value. On Saturday, you'll need a wristband to see the Houston Texans
Lamar
player.
Miller.
Lamar Miller will be here starting at 1 o'clock for autographs. So you need to get a wristband if you want to be guaranteed an autograph by him. And of course, there'll be lots of exciting things going on, those giveaways throughout the day here at Dick's. So you might as well just plan on spending your whole weekend here.
Gotcha. I do want to ask a real quick question, because I don't know, as a golfer, to me it's important that when I go to shop, that the people who work in that department, I mean, that's what they do all the time. In other words, I don't want to come in and some guy that just came from shoes is trying to sell me a golf club. Is that kind of what they do there?
Yeah, let me grab him real quick and I'll show you. We have our, I just want to show the golf expert here. James, my passion is golf. So he's not coming from the shoe department. He is the golf expert here, and they have a whole team of individuals that know what they're talking about. Okay. They'll be able to recommend the right club for you.
And that's good. And I hope it's that way in all the departments, you know, that when you go to buy shoes, that the person there goes, okay, you know, that's what I do. I can sell you shoes. Kelsey, thanks. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow, of course, bright and early. Thank you for being with us this morning. But don't go away just yet. We got one more check of the forecast.
We do, and we'll look ahead to the Friday edition of the Morning Show.
I mean, pretty much the way we always start it, with a look at what's happening outside, because we know you're headed that direction, and it is going to be warm today.
Yeah, a warm day. It wasn't quite as warm to start off as far as our temperatures are concerned. However, we'll be reaching the middle to upper 80s pretty quickly today with high humidity readings to boot. We're looking at a partly cloudy sky today and tomorrow. And by tomorrow, even though we're still calling for all of the other elements to remain the same, we'll also be adding a rain chance in at 20%.
Is there any reason that we couldn't go up and do like Fridays up at, can we take the picture of Rayburn Country up at, that we couldn't just do the entire show on Fridays? I mean, look at that.
I'd be down
Aren't
for that.
Aren't we speaking to the executive producer of the show?
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
You're asking.
Yeah. He pulls a lot of weight.
All you have to do is say, report to duty right there.
We'll be there.
That. I would love that. Right there out of a big glass window, maybe looking out.
Wouldn't that be nice?
All right. That being said, we will be back here tomorrow morning, bright and early at 4:30 a.m. We'll catch you up on the latest headlines. Good Food Friday?
Yeah. We're going to Boardwalk Cafe out of Orange is going to be cooking up.
Oh, that sounds good.
Outdoor
we'll look forward
kitchen.
To that. That sounds like fun. All right. So enjoy your day. We'll see you back here bright and early tomorrow morning. Till then, well, be good, I guess.
Yeah.
Best I can think of. Yeah. Stay out of trouble, which isn't easy for us.